Hello, YouTube. It's been a while. I'm on a hike today. It's a new place for me. It's called the Upland Farm Sanctuary. I guess you would call it Cold Spring Harbor, maybe Syosset, Long Island. It's not a very big place. There are two trails here. Each one is about 1.2 miles. You know, unfortunately, the weather here in the Northeast has been absolutely terrible this winter. And it's raining. So last week we got about a foot of snow. And the last few days it's been raining on and off. But there are quite a few cars here. I mean, much more than I expected. And there are some people that work here. I don't know if you can see behind me. Well, maybe when we get out. You can see a house back there. You see it? Those are offices for the Nature Conservancy. And that's where this is located. That was someone's house. And when she died, she donated it to the Nature Conservancy. And this is where they have their offices on Long Island. So I'm going to get out of the car. It is raining. It's not raining terribly hard, but it is raining. And we'll see what we can get done today. So here we are, we're at the head of the trail. We can't hunt or fish here, which is fine. But let's see where we're gonna go. No dogs allowed either. No metal detecting allowed either. Okay, maybe there's something we can do. So I guess it's a loop. All right, this is the Davidson Trail, Davison Trail, and it's telling us to go this way, so let's go this way. And I guess we're going to end up over there, but we'll just follow it. On the trail map, it was blue, so I guess there'll be blue blazes if there are at all. There may not even be, because it's only the one trail. Very nice. You can see see all the cars there and the house, which are their offices. And that's where we just came from. So if it doesn't rain any harder, it won't be a problem. But I am getting wet. A week ago, yesterday I guess, we had a big storm. Depending on where you were on Long Island, just to show you, you got anywhere from a few inches to as much as 19 inches. There was Islip, Babylon, that area, got 19 inches. We got about a foot where I live. But notice it's all gone. It's supposed to be great for bird watching here. It's something I've always wanted to do but never really took advantage of. Now let's see, there's some kind of a junction down here. This might be where the other trail splits off. There's something called the West Trail as well. And let's see. West Loop Trail. Now each one of these trails is about 1.2 miles. Here's Davidson. Let's do Davidson. And if the weather clears up, look at this house. What a magnificent house. this area of Long Island is very affluent, let's say. Beautiful houses. They probably pay more in real estate taxes than you and I make for a year. Now here's some snow, leftover snow. This must be nice in the spring and summer when this all grows in. And from being other places like this, there's a lot of birds like to live in this brush type of environment. Another nice house. It's nice when they put these parks in the middle of the residential areas. You get to be secluded without being secluded. Is that a good way of saying it? So it's been a while since I've made videos like this. I mean to, but just don't pull the trigger for whatever reason. The winter's been terrible. We went through a very, very cold spell back in late December, early January. Then the flu season hit, and I don't think I really got the flu, but I got something, and I was sick on and off for several weeks. And then we got snow on and off. I go back to school Martin Luther King Day, the day after. And from then, which I guess was around January 17th to just last week, I think we missed 5 days of school. And we got the bad news, we gotta make one of them up. Here's a bench, let's see. Usually here, there's some loving memory, Tony Coe, 1997. Now, Coe is a family name here on Long Island. There's another park, state park, called the Planting Fields Arboretum. We have to go make a video there too. And there is a old mansion there called Coe Hall. So I'm wondering if it's not in the family. Now there are these side trails you see, but these could go onto someone's property. So I think you want to stay on the, what's this? Huh. There is a sign with an arrow pointing that way. I'm gonna stay off that today. My first time here, really, and yeah, I'll just stay off it. So anyway, I've been meaning to make videos like this all winter, but for the reasons I just gave you, it wasn't possible. So with the spring coming up, I'm all excited. I'm gonna try out some new places. Make some videos for you all. In terms of my life, I have no complaints. Everything is going great. I have great family. I have great kids, a great wife, and a grandson. I have no complaints. Everyone is not only doing well, they're thriving. They're all working and doing the thing they love to do. So, no complaints from me. I have three children, adults. They're each married now. All three have great spouses, great families they married into. I can honestly say I could have no problems with anybody. My job, I'm a teacher. Good things going on there. Working very hard. A lot of people think teachers don't work hard. Trust me, they do. Well, maybe some do. So, you will get no complaints from me about anything. The semester is about half over. A little more than half over. We've got probably 6 weeks or so to go. Still a lot of work to be done. And one of the problems is with these snow days and breaks. It's spring break right now. I'm on spring break. Students lose momentum. And I mean, let's face it, being young people, they don't spend enough time on their work. You know, it's unfortunate. So with all the starts and stops, it's very challenging as a teacher to work with that. Because you have to keep moving forward, but you have to recognize that a lot of the students, or at least a substantial portion, are not moving forward. So you gotta try to compensate for that. How do you do that? What do you do with kindness? What do you do with yelling and screaming? Well, I think it's a combination. All right, so here's the main road that I turned off of when I got here. And there's some, it's kind of a school or something across the street. I see soccer nets and bleachers over there. And this is where we turned in. Now, I wonder, can we cut across this way? Again, since this is the first day, do not proceed along this trail, all right? So that means don't go that way. That was my question. I was considering going that way. I can be like that too, so it's not fair to rank on them. Okay, so this is where you come in.
So this is Cold Spring Harbor. Okay. This is Cold Spring Harbor Junior and Senior High School. And my kids, when they were in school, they played sports against them. Oh, I forget what sports. Fencing, I think. And so we were here several times. It's a beautiful school. You don't even know you're on Long Island. You think you're like in California or something. The school is beautiful. Bathrooms. You know how public bathrooms, how disgusting they are? Well, the bathrooms that they had were nicer than the bathroom you have in your house. Misting, full-blown raining, but it's just a miserable day. So here you can see the house down here, which are their offices. There's some bird feeders, it looks like. So when we get back down to the end of this trail, I'm guessing that's the 1.2 miles. Now I'm gonna, when I get to the end of the trail, turn it off. And then we're gonna march back down to the West Trail. And try that. So let's see. Geese there, I don't know if you can see them. Canada geese. I don't know if you're aware of it or not. Canada geese does not mean the geese are from Canada. The geese are named after person that kind of discovered them, who was a man named John Canada. So that's what Canada geese, that's where the Canada comes from. Not from the country. So they're not Canadian geese, right? Sometimes you'll hear people call them Canadian geese. They're not Canadian geese. They're Canada geese, named after John Canada. So there, you learned something today, maybe. They look like some nice healthy ones. They must have plenty to eat here. So you can see that's basically where we started, that little shed in the background there. And those are the cars, mine's at the one at the end. So I'm going to turn this off now, and we'll come back on when we get to the West Trail.